Again, I want to thank you for coming tonight. It's great to have everybody. Tomorrow night, the Lord willing, the creek don't rise and we don't get flooded out. We're going to go to, Kaiser, West Virginia. Preaching a tent meeting there. You will be welcome to go with us. We will take vans and buses and whatever we need to carry you up the hill. We need to leave about 5:30, I would say. So if you want to go, let me know after church. We'll figure out what we need to take to accommodate everybody. And as many as can go, let's go up there. Brother Shoemaker is trying to get that church going again. And Brother Brock is having a tent revival up there, and they asked us to preach tomorrow night, so we're going to go. I planned to go anyway. I told him I was going to come anyway, and then he called me on the way to Richland and said he wanted me to preach. So let's plan on that. Don't forget services Sunday morning and Sunday night, and let's come praying and believe in the Lord to help us. Would you do that? Psalm 142 tonight. Psalm 142. Need your prayers tonight. I don't know, just not enough sleep, or running too much, or I don't know what. I preached Wednesday, very sweaty, and I didn't have a shirt with me, and I don't know if I got chilled or what, but I felt rather rough today. But if the Lord will help me not to fear, by the grace of God, we're going to preach to you. Psalm 142, I love this psalm. And I felt like the Lord spoke to me that I was to preach from this psalm tonight. Listen, and let's listen to God's Word. I cried unto the Lord with my voice. With my voice unto the Lord did I make my supplication. I poured out my complaint before Him. I showed before Him my trouble. When my spirit was overwhelmed within me, then Thou knewest my path. And the way wherein I walk, have they privily laid a snare for me. I looked on my right hand, and behold, but there was no man that would know me. Refuge failed me. No man cared for my soul. I cried unto thee, O Lord, I said, Thou art my refuge and my portion in the land of the living. Attend unto my cry. I'm brought very low. Deliver me from my persecutors, for they're stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison, that I may praise Thy name. The righteous shall compass me about, for Thou shalt deal bountifully with me. Shall we pray? Brother Fulcher, why don't you stand tonight, pray and ask God to help me. Will you do that? Praise God.
Father, we appreciate you. Appreciate the hour you've given to us. We ask now that you come by, touch Brother Paul, and minister to us, strengthen each heart, each soul. I ask Lord, that you give the word of God. They may be bringing to us.
Amen. I want to preach a little while tonight on what to do when you don't know what to do. I like that. What to do when you don't know what to do. Let me ask you a question tonight. Have you ever been in a situation where you did not know what to do? Huh? You felt like you needed to do something. You felt like that you had to do something, but you didn't know what to do. I don't know. Reading some commentary, they seem to think that David possibly wrote this when he was in the cave of Engadi. David spent a lot of time in the cave of Adullam, hiding from Saul and the Philistines. But they seemed to think that this was the cave of Engadi, where that David was, when Saul had him completely surrounded. And there was no way out. And he did not know what to do. I want you to know tonight that it is the devil's plan to make you think that you have no choice, that you have no move, that you have no life, that you have no hope. Brother, he wants to get you to a place to where you say, I don't know what to do. Hallelujah. I told you before, but I think it's certainly worth telling again about that famous painting called Checkmate there in the museum in Germany. There's a chessboard. And standing on one side of the chessboard is the devil. And he's glaring down at this man who's on the other side. And he's disrupted and disheveled and distressed. And as the board was set, he didn't have another move. And it was called checkmate. The devil had this man in checkmate. One day a chess player came there, and he saw that, and it just worked on him. He saw that poor man, and the agony in his face. And oh, he just kept walking. And he'd look, and he'd walk. And he'd look, and he'd study, and he'd walk. Now that day, the next day, I think for 7 days he came and just looked and walked. And all of a sudden, he screamed out. He's got another move. He's got another move. Woo! Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to tell you tonight, when the devil says he's got your checkmate, when the devil says you've got no hope, when the devil says you can't make it, I want to tell you, as long as there's a God, you've got another move. Say hallelujah. Lift your hands and praise him tonight. Woo! Oh yeah. Glory. As long as there's breath, as long as there's God, as long as there's the Holy Ghost, if you are a child of God, you have got another move, because God is on your side and he's going to bring you out of your distress and of your brokenhearted situation. Hallelujah. Glory. I want to preach on three aspects of this psalm that I read to you tonight. First thing I want to talk about is the cry of this man. Hallelujah. Oh my God, here's what he said. He said, my spirit was overwhelmed. Oh God. Woo. I just felt overwhelmed. My situation seemed so black. My situation seemed so helpless. Oh my God, it seemed as if there was no light. Oh, pray for me, church. It seemed that there was no light at the end of the tunnel. It seemed that there was no end to the night. It seemed there was no end to my troubles. It seemed there was no end to the enemy that had me surrounded. It seemed there was no end to the tears that ran down my eyes. My heart was overwhelmed. I was crying out to God. I said, God, my heart is overwhelmed. Oh, hallelujah. When he said, I poured out my complaint. Oh, my God, how many of us have went off somewhere, got in a bedroom, got in, you know, come to church, fell out at the altar, and began to pour out the complaint. God, I'm sick, and I can't get well. God, I'm broke, and I don't see the way out of my broken mess. God, I've got trouble, and I don't see no hope for my despair. God, my back
ashes to the wall, and my night is black, and my tears have been my meat night and day. Well, they say, where is thy God? You begin to cry out, God, oh God, I want to pour out my complaint and tell you what my problem is. Hallelujah. Oh, I would say that more than one of us here, even in our lifetime, has found a place and cried out to God and said, God, here it is. Here's where I'm at. Here's my situation. Here's the cry of my heart. Here's the tears of my eyes. Here's the distress of my heart. I'm doing what I can. I'm getting pushed further back. I'm in distress. I'm overwhelmed. The harder I try and see the Father, I get pushed back. I'm overwhelmed. God, this is my situation. If that wasn't enough, he goes on and he said, Lord, no man will know me. Well, the things I have learned, the bitter lessons of life that I have learned, that when people think that you're on the rise, there will be many that will try to grab your coattails. Are you still here? Amen. As long as they think that you're on the rise, they'll grab your coattails and say, pull me up with you. But you'll find the sad truth of the matter is when you get down on the bottom, you'll find that many of them have disappeared. He said, Lord, when I was high, Lord, when I was blessed, Lord, when I was on the pinnacle, everybody knew me. But now that I'm down, and now that I'm broken, and now that I'm torn, and I'm in distress, no man will know me. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Oh, yeah. Oh, you might as well tell the truth. We might as well say amen tonight. Oh, let's just tell it like it is. We say, preacher, man, I've got enough of my old troubles. I don't have time to worry about yours. I've got enough of my old troubles to worry about. You and God will have to work that out the best you can. Oh, I don't think that's what God wants us to do. But David said, here I am. I'm left alone. Oh, could it have been? Could it have been? Could it have been that this happened? And he wrote this when he came back and found Ziklag burned to the ground and they spoke of stoning him. Could it have been then when he said, no man cared for my soul. No one knew me. No one was concerned about me. I was down. I was out. They cast me aside. I was overwhelmed. I was distressed. I poured out my complaint to the God of heaven. No man would know me. He said, refuge failed me. Oh, my God. He said, I couldn't find any refuge. I couldn't find a place to hide. Come on here now, help me preach. I could not find a place of respite. I could not find a place of rest. I could not find a place that I could find refuge. I was left alone. I stood on the mountain alone. I stood against the enemy alone. I stood in my despair. My heart is overwhelmed. Oh, hallelujah. Where he said, I poured out my complaint. Oh my God, how many of us have went off somewhere, got in a bedroom, got in, come to church, fell down at the altar, and began to pour out the complaint. God, I'm sick and I can't get well. God, I'm broke and I don't see the way out of my broken mess. God, I've got trouble and I don't see no hope for my despair. God, my back is to the wall and my night is black and my tears have been my meat night and day. Well, they say, where is thy God? You begin to cry out, God, oh God, I want to pour out my complaint and tell you what my problem is. Hallelujah. Oh, I would say that more than one of us here, even in our lifetime, has found a place and cried out to God and said, God, here it is. Here's where I'm at. Here's my situation. Here's the cry of my heart. Here's the tears of my eyes. Here's the distress of my heart. I'm doing what I can. I'm getting pushed further back. I'm in distress. I'm overwhelmed. The harder I try and see the Father, I get pushed back. I'm overwhelmed. God, this is my situation. If that wasn't enough, he goes on and he said, Lord, no man will know me. Oh, what are the things I have learned? What have been the lessons of life that I have learned? That when people think that you're on the rise, there will be many that will try to grab your coattails. Are you still here? Amen. As long as they think that you're on the rise, they'll grab your coattails and say, pull me up with you. But you'll find the sad truth of the matter is when you get down on the bottom, you'll find that many of them have disappeared. He said, Lord, when I was high, Lord, when I was blessed, Lord, when I was on the pinnacle, everybody knew me. But now that I'm down, and now that I'm broken, and now that I'm torn, and now I'm in distress, no man will know me. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, you might as well tell the truth. We might as well say amen tonight. Oh, let's just tell it like it is. We say, preacher, man, I've got enough of my own troubles. I don't have time to worry about yours. I've got enough of my own troubles to worry about. You and God will have to work that out the best you can. Oh, I don't think that's what God wants us to do. But David said, here I am. I'm left alone. Oh, could it have been? Could it have been? Could it have been that this happened? And he wrote this when he came back and found Ziklag burned to the ground and they spoke of stoning him. Could it have been then when he said, no man cared for my soul. No one knew me. No one was concerned about me. I was down. I was out. They cast me aside. I was overwhelmed. I was distressed. I poured out my complaint to the God of heaven. No man would know me. He said, rest you failed me. Oh, my God. He said, I couldn't find any refuge. I couldn't find a place to hide. Come on here now, help me preach. I could not find the place of respite. I could not find the place of rest. I could not find the place that I could find refuge. I was left alone. I stood on the mountain alone. I stood against the enemy alone. I stood in my distress alone. I stood overwhelmed alone. I was broken alone. No man cared for me. There was no refuge. My heart was overwhelmed. Woo! My God, my God. Let me tell you something here. I don't care who you are. It don't make any difference how much money you had or did not have. It would make little or no difference the amount of money that you have. Everybody has to feel like that somebody wants them. That somebody loves them. That somebody cares for them. Oh, my God. There's no more tormenting voice. There's no more tormenting spirit than to feel you're alone. To feel that nobody cares. To feel that nobody's concerned. That nobody's worried about your trouble. Nobody cares you're sick. Nobody cares you're broke. Nobody cares you're brokenhearted. Nobody cares you're going through a trial. Nobody cares you're lost. Nobody cares about your soul. My God, that was his cry. Nobody cares. I'm overwhelmed. I'm destitute. And I've got no refuge for my soul. Woo! Oh, my God, my God, my God. I tell you, look at your... If my name is Paul Markee, there are some of you sitting right here tonight. The devil's told you very things, even that I'm reading to you. You have felt distressed. You have felt discouraged. You have felt all alone. You felt like God forgot you. You forgot like your friends forgot you. You felt like your situation is hopeless. Come on here. My God, you're overwhelmed. You're distressed. You're discouraged. You're downhearted. My God, you're depressed here tonight. My God, I want to tell you something. I've got some news for you. The God of heaven has heard your cry. The God of heaven has seen your tears. The God of heaven knows where you're at tonight. Let me get these voice and preach to you tonight. Woo! Hey, hey, hey! Oh, great God. I said, great God of heaven. You know, I'm a kind of guy that I've always worked and always been able to work and always been willing to work. I've always been a man that, you know,
Don't misunderstand me. I have to have this highly abused life. I'm not here to whine. But you know, bless God, I've had several kicks to the curb. Hallelujah. I've had several folks that put their foot on my neck and tried to hold me down. I've had more than one person that's wished for my destruction. Oh, I've been there. But you don't see, my guy can always just shake it off and come on up out of it. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you, there will come a time. I said there will come a time when you realize that at 58, you're not the same man you was at 38. When you realize the sands of time are running out, that your options will not be forever. Come on here now. Hey! And the devil says, you're going to lose your church, and you're going to lose your mind, and you're going to lose everything you got. Even your health is gone. Somebody help me. Your wife's health is gone. Hey, brother, it's dark all around you. I'm going to tell you, I've been there. I know the darkness. I know the tears. I know the cry. There's no refuge. There's no help. There's nobody, it seems, that cares for your soul. Woo!
Hallelujah.
You are here tonight. I said, you are here tonight. Pray for me, saints. I got a message to preach. I got something from God. I got to preach to someone tonight. Pray to God to help me. Not just one. I believe there's several folks here tonight that God is sending a message to. I don't say that lightly. This is not something I got out of a book. This is something God spoke to me. I'm telling you tonight, there's more than one person here. That only God knows the agony of your soul. Only God knows the battle that's been going on in your mind.
Oh, somebody help me preach.
I want to tell you, the mind is the battleground of the soul. And I'm here to tell you, sitting right in this building tonight, you are here, and the devil has been tormenting your mind. Woo! Woo! He has told you God don't care. He has told you God don't hear. He has told you that no one cares for your soul, and no one knows your trouble, and no one knows your distress, and no one has seen the night that you cried yourself to sleep because there was nobody there. Come on here. You said nobody saw me, preacher, the night I cried, and nobody saw my tears. I've got some news for you. The master saw your tears, and not only did he see him, but he's got a model up. He knows you. He loves you. He cares for you. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Woo! Oh my God. The cry
of this man. I said the cry of this broken man. Oh, that felt alone. That felt discouraged, that felt despondent, that felt hopeless. Come on here. My God, have you ever felt hopeless? I said, have you ever felt hopeless?
Yes,
this man felt hopeless, and he felt helpless, and he said, no one cares, and nobody sees, and nobody knows, but God sees, and God knows, and God cares. Oh, hallelujah. That was the cry of the psalmist. But then I hear from his lips, there comes a petition. And the cry is followed by the petition. And the petition says, oh God, whoo, bring my soul out of prison. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Glory, glory. The psalmist recognized that he was in a prison.
I said he recognized that he was in a prison. I want to tell you tonight that sometimes we are in prisons that are brought upon by the powers of the devil. And your health is gone. Ah, somebody help me. Your wife's health is gone. Hey, brother, it's dark all around you. I'm going to tell you, I've been there. I know the darkness. I know the tears. I know the cry. There's no refuge. There's no help. There's nobody, it seems, that cares for your soul. Woo!
Hallelujah.
You are here tonight. I said, you are here tonight. Pray for me, saints. I got a message to preach. I got something from God. I got to preach to someone tonight. Pray to God to help me. Not just one. I believe there's several folks here tonight that God is sending a message to. I don't say that lightly. This is not something I got out of a book. This is something God spoke to me. I'm telling you tonight, there's more than one person here. That only God knows the agony of your soul. Only God knows the battle that's been going on in your mind.
Oh, somebody help me preach.
I want to tell you, the mind is the battleground of the soul. And I'm here to tell you, sitting right in this building tonight, you are here, and the devil has been tormenting your mind.
Woo! God,
woo! He has told you God don't care. He has told you God don't hear. He has told you that no one cares for your soul, and no one knows your trouble, and no one knows your distress, and no one has seen the night that you cried yourself to sleep because there was nobody there. Come on here. I said, you said nobody saw me, preacher, the night I cried, and nobody saw my tears. I've got some news for you. The master saw your tears, and not only did he see him, but he's got a model up. He knows you. He loves you. He cares for you. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Woo! Oh my God. The cry
of this man. I said the cry of this broken man. Oh, that felt alone. That felt discouraged, that felt despondent, that felt hopeless. Come on here. My God, have you ever felt hopeless? I said, have you ever felt hopeless?
Yes.
This man felt hopeless, and he felt helpless, and he said, no one cares, and nobody sees, and nobody knows, but God sees, and God knows, and God cares. Oh, hallelujah. That was the cry of the psalmist. But then I hear from his lips, there comes a petition. And the cry is followed by the petition. And the petition says, oh God, whoo, bring my soul out of prison. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Glory, glory. The psalmist recognized that he was in a prison. I said he recognized that he was in a prison. I want to tell you tonight that sometimes we are in prisons that are brought upon by the powers of the devil. And then there are other times that we're brought in, we're in prisons, but that we have chosen for ourselves. We have chosen the prison that we're living in. But whatever your situation tonight, whether the devil has got you in the prison house, or if you've chosen the prison yourself, and then there's a cry that needs to come out of your lips tonight. You need to cry, Lord, bring my soul out of prison. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost about that. Woo! Hear the preacher man tonight. There are some of you here tonight. The Lord told me to tell you that you're in a prison house of sin. I said you're in a prison house of sin. And the devil's got you. And he's got his grip around you. And he's got you pulled down. And he's got you locked down. And you're bound by habits. And you're bound by chains of sin that you can't seem to break out of. Hallelujah. Oh, preacher, I'd like to be saved. I'd like to know God. I'd like to get right with God. But I feel like I'm in a prison. I feel like the devil's got the key. I can't quit my cigarettes. I can't quit my alcohol. I can't quit my drugs. I can't quit my lying. I can't quit my cussing. Oh, listen. I don't care what kind of prison that you may think you're in. I feel the power of the Holy Ghost. And all God wants to hear is a cry of your lips that says, God of heaven, bring my soul out of prison. I've got to have deliverance out of the prison that I'm bound in.
Oh, glory. I said, glory.
I said, hallelujah.
You know, I'm going to mention this in
passing tonight. It's not exactly what my message is about, but I'm going to mention it in passing tonight. Somebody knows what this is. A phone. To be more particular, it happens to be an iPhone. Hallelujah. We got smartphones. And I guess if we got smartphones, I guess we got dumb phones. Hallelujah. So I don't know if you got a smartphone or a dumb phone or an iPhone or a he phone or a she phone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But it's very interesting. Within about a month period at the youth camp at Mount Olive, Brother Brett preaching one afternoon. And the young boy came up and wept and cried and wept and cried and wept and cried. And suddenly went back to his feet and got something out of his pocket and came back up to the altar and took his cell phone and slammed it against the wall. I was in a service last night, and a young boy came up, probably 21, 22, and he's weeping and crying, and all of a sudden he looks up. He says, I got to go get my cell phone. And he goes and he gets, I think he had a smartphone, but he wasn't too smart, I reckon. And so he brings it back, and he goes to stopping it and trying to bend it. And before he got out, he said, hey, he said, I've been watching pornography. He said, this phone is ruining me, and I can't serve God. Now hear me. Here's what I want to tell you. I'm not preaching against cell phones or iPhones or smartphones or any other kind of phone. But here's what I'm going to tell you. Whatever's got you in prison, my God, you better let go of it. Whatever's got you down, let go of it. Whatever's dragging you down, you better let go of it. Whatever's got you in prison, you better say, God, I've got to be set free out of the prison that I'm bound in.
Hallelujah.
I said, hallelujah. Woo! Come on here. My God, this man said, Lord, you got to bring my soul out of prison. And I felt like telling someone here tonight, the devil's had you in a prison of despair. Huh? And the devil's had you in a prison of discouragement. Woo! Glory! 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 I said glory! Oh, the devil got you in a prison. You couldn't be any more bound. If you was in Sing Sing, you couldn't be any more bound. If you was in a maximum security prison, the devil got you discouraged. The devil got you in despair. The devil got you depressed. The devil got you down. But the Holy Ghost said to tell you tonight, he wants to bring your soul out of prison. The Holy Ghost said, I'm going to liberate. The Holy Ghost said, I'm going to set you free. And he cried, bring my soul out of prison. Lift your hand tonight. Woo! Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. My God, somebody needs to pray for this preacher, man. Let God help me preach tonight.
Woo! Oh, glory. We sing that song. You won't leave here like you came in Jesus' name. Bound, oppressed, tormented, sick, or lame. Oh, hallelujah. For the Holy Ghost of Acts is still the same. You won't leave here like you came in Jesus' name. I'm here to tell you under the authority of the Holy Ghost, somebody tonight, my God, needs to get up. Somebody tonight, heaven needs to get up and get out of your prison. You need to get out of the dungeon that the devil got you bound in. There's liberty. There's life. There's Christ. There's deliverance. Bring my soul out of prison with the protection of the psalmist. Hallelujah. You, my friend, have got to get tired of the circumstances. You have got to get tired of what the devil's putting you through. You, my friend, have got to realize, yes, I do not deny that the devil has got a prison house. Woo! But what I also know, hallelujah, that there is one who set the captive free. I know the one who's got the keys to death, hell, and the grave. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of despair. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of despondency. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of sin. I feel him walking in this church. I feel him walking in these aisles. All he wants is for you to say, bring my soul out of prison. Hallelujah!
Woo!
Let me tell you what's going on with some of you right here tonight. Let me tell you exactly what's going on with some of you. It's like the story that I told you about that Dr. Fields who went to Africa. And there, he went to one of those prisons. A horrible, horrible prison. He said that he went inside the first chamber of this prison. And there were men and women working slavishly, making baskets. Poor, dying, wasting away. But working. I said, glory! Oh, the devil got you in a prison. You couldn't be any more. You couldn't be any more bound. It's if you was in Sing Sing, you couldn't be any more bound. If you was in a maximum security prison, the devil got you discouraged. The devil got you in despair. The devil got you depressed. The devil got you down. But the Holy Ghost said to tell you tonight, he wants to bring your soul out of prison. The Holy Ghost said, I want to liberate. The Holy Ghost said, I want to set you free. And he cried, bring my soul out of prison. Lift your hand tonight. Woo! Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. My God, somebody needs to pray for this prison, man. But God, every prison, man.
Oh, glory. We sing that song. You won't leave here like you came in Jesus' name. Bound, oppressed, tormented, sick, or lame. Oh, hallelujah. For the Holy Ghost of Acts is still the same. You won't leave here like you came in Jesus' name. I'm here to tell you under the authority of the Holy Ghost, somebody tonight, my God needs to get up. Somebody tonight, heaven needs to get up and get out of your prison. You need to get out of the dungeon that the devil got you bound in. There's liberty. There's life. There's Christ. There's deliverance. Bring my soul out of prison with the protection of the psalmist. Hallelujah. You, my friend, have got to get tired of the circumstances. You have got to get tired of what the devil's putting you through. You, my friend, have got to realize, yes, I do not deny that the devil has done a prison house. Woo! But what I also know, hallelujah, that there is one who set the captive free. I know the one who's got the keys to death, hell, and the grave. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of despair. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of despondency. I know the one who's got the key to the prison house of sin. I feel him walking in this church. I feel him walking in these aisles. All he wants is for you to say, bring my soul out of prison. Hallelujah.
Woo.
Let me tell you what's going on with some of you right here tonight. Let me tell you exactly what's going on with some of you. It's like the story that I told you about that Dr. Fields who went to Africa. And there, he went to one of those prisons. A horrible, horrible prison. He said that he went inside the first chamber of his prison. And there were men and women working slavishly, making baskets. Poor, dying, wasting away. But working. But then they took him into the horror, the chamber of horrors. They took him to the second chamber. And there chained to the walls were men and women who were dying. They were like those victims, if you've ever seen those of the Holocaust, little by little. They were dying. They were just some of them days and some of them hours from dying. What if Dr. Fields was so moved? Then he went to town. He begged permission. He said, can I get these people something to eat? And he said, well, all right. So he went to town and he bought a loaf of bread for every person in that prison, those in the first chamber and those in the second. And he gave them that piece of bread and they just devoured it. They just stuffed it in their mouth. Oh, you know what the tragedy was? You know what the tragedy was, sister? My God. If he had to turn around and he had to leave them chained to the walls. He had to leave them, my brother, bound in the prison house. Oh, my God. That loaf of bread gave him a little temporary ease, but he left them bound in the prison house. And that's the problem with some of you here. You come to church and you get just a little touch. Woo! You get a little bit of bread. Well, I've come to tell you there's more to it than that. Whom the sun sets free is free indeed. You can leave here liberated. You can leave here free. You can leave here shouting. You can leave here saved by the power of the grace of the Son of Almighty God. Hallelujah. I feel deliverance in the house tonight. God wants to set somebody free. Well, glory to God. Hallelujah. A little more. And then finally, after the cry, after the petition, he comes to a realization. And here's what it is. Here's what it is. He said, thou knewest my path. Oh, glory to God. I need to say that one more time. Thou knewest my path. Oh, glory. I want to say that one more time. Thou knewest my path. Job said, he knows the way that I take. Brother Marty, he didn't say I would know. Job didn't say he knew. Job didn't say I know. But what Job said was, he knows. He knows. I don't understand it right now. Huh? Brother, folks, it ain't all quite adding up just right now. Just exactly how, it ain't all quite working out just like it ought to work out. It ain't quite worked out like we thought. But hey, I got some good news for you, brother. You're not going to die in the prison. You're not going to die overwhelmed. He knows the way that you take, and you will come forth. I said you will come forth. There will be rejoicing. There will be shouting. There will be dancing. There will be rejoicing, because the God of heaven is going to bring you out of the prison house. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I said hallelujah. What did you say? Well, my heart is overwhelmed within me. I'm going to throw in the towel. I'm going to give up on God. I'm going to let the devil have the day. He said, someone come and get me. And he said, lead me to the rock that's higher than I. Yeah, bring me on up a little higher. Ah, glory. When I'm overwhelmed, when I'm in prison, when it's dark all around, hey, come on here. When it's dark all around me and I'm overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that's higher than I. I'll find a refuge. I'll find a solace. I'll find deliverance. I'll find grace. Just somebody lead me to the rock that's higher than I. Have I not seen? Do I not know, saith the Lord of hosts? Have not I spoken unto thee this night? Yes, and revealed unto my servant things that you have told no one. Yea, but I know the way you take. I see your tears in the night. I know the cry of your heart, saith the Lord. And I desire to bring thee out of the prison. I desire to set thee upon a rock and establish thy going. I desire to put a new song in the heart, even a song of praise unto thy God. Many shall see it. Many shall be blessed. Many shall see, and they shall fear the Lord. Yea, trust in me, and I shall bring thy soul out of prison. Lift your hand tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God, well, I lost my job, and my ears are hurting, I can't hear, and I just sort of feel overwhelmed, and I feel like the devil got me in a prison. He said, but somebody get me, and lead me on up to the rock. Hallelujah. That's a little higher than I am. When I'm overwhelmed, when I'm distressed, when I don't know which way to turn, oh hallelujah, my God, come on, host shall come by my side. When I feel like I'm in prison, I need that somebody, and they get a hold of my hand. Somebody take me to prayer. Somebody take me to God. Somebody take me to the rock. That's higher than I. I'm gonna have deliverance. I'm gonna have a touch. I'm gonna have God's power. Somebody is gonna touch God. I'm gonna come out of prison. Oh, lift your hands and praise Him tonight. You don't know how to do it. You don't know how to do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe the Lord's here tonight. I said, I believe the Lord's here tonight. I want you to stand to your feet right now. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Woo. Hallelujah. I said, I feel the Holy Ghost here tonight. I feel like I had a message from heaven. I feel like the devil has been dragging down. I believe it has been tormenting this young lady. He's been tormenting my brother. Hallelujah. Come on here. My God, somebody has got to get a hold of God. Somebody has got to say there's a rock that's higher. Somebody has got to say there's a limit in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Woo! Come and gather around these that are here praying tonight. And if you need prayer, come on up here. Sure. My God, we want to pray with you. If you're tired of being in prison, if you want to come out, then come down to this altar. We're going to pray with you tonight.
I do not know how others make it through. They never go to Calvary as I do. For there's a healing, cleansing stream that flows, that streams out all evil, redeems and all. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Oh, for all my sins, my
put my hand. Somebody take me to prayer. Somebody take me to God. Somebody take me to the rock. The time of the night. I've got to have deliverance. I've got to have a touch. Power! Somebody is going to touch God. I'm going to come out of prison. Ah, lift your hands and praise Him. Hallelujah. I believe the Lord's here tonight. I said, I believe the Lord's here tonight. I want you to stand to your feet right now. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Woo. Hallelujah. I said, I feel the Holy Ghost here tonight. I feel like I had a message from heaven. I feel like the devil has been dragging down. I believe it's been tormenting this young lady. He's been tormenting my brother. Hallelujah. Come on here. My God, somebody has got to get a hold of God. Somebody has got to say there's a rock that's higher. Somebody has got to say there's a limit in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Woo! God, lift your hand right now. Lift your hand right now, my God, in the name of Jesus. Woo! Somebody, I said, somebody needs to say, Lord, bring my soul out of prison. I've got to have deliverance. I've got to have a touch. I've got to know God's power. Hallelujah. Why don't we come and gather around these that are here praying tonight. And if you need prayer, come on up here. Sure. My God, we want to pray with you. If you're tired of being in prison, if you want to come out, then come down to this altar. We're going to pray with you tonight.
I do not know how others make it through. They never go to Calvary as I do. For there's a healing, cleansing stream that flows, that speaks out all evil, redeemed can know. I claim the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. Those precious blood stains were made there just for me. Oh, for all my sins, my sickness and my pain. When I need healing, I claim.
Hey, let's sing it again. Pray tonight. I said, let's sing it again. Pray tonight.
I pray the blood Jesus shed on Calvary. The precious blood stains were made there just for me. Oh, for my sins, my sickness and my pain. When I need healing, I claim those prayers. Those precious blood stains
were made there just for me. For all my sins, my sickness and my pain, when I need healing, I claim those precious blood stains. And oh, Jesus is my high tower, a lion, a dark hour. Without him, where would I be? For he is closer than a brother. Without him, there's no other. Without him, where would I be? Oh, Jesus, what a friend is he. And though he is a rock upon which I stand, oh, he's a perfect help in time of need. And when this soul out has left me all alone, oh, I can feel him walking right by me. When everyone walks out, that's when he walks in. Oh, proving once again that he's my dear son.
Somebody's coming out of prison tonight.
He promised
he'd
go with me always.
Prison tonight.
Until the end. He is a rock upon which I stand. Oh, he's a present help in time of need. Oh, and this soul out has left me all alone. And I can feel him walking right by me. When everyone walks out, that's when he walks in. Proving once again that he's my dearest friend. He promised he'd go with me always. And oh, he promised he'd go with me always, even till the end. Well, now in this day we live in, there's evil everywhere. The body gets discouraged and overcome with fear. But God is needing soldiers to get out of the pew and take hold of the power that God and Peter used. He said, get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. The Lord is calling daily for those who would be saved. Well, don't go down defeated, I'll be chasing the flame. Well, get up, get up, well, get up in Jesus' name. Well, get up in Jesus' name, get up in Jesus' name. Get up in Jesus' name. Get up in Jesus' name. The Lord is calling daily for those who would be saved. Well, all go down to fear, I'll increase in claim. So get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. Well, now in this day we live in, there's evil everywhere. The body gets discouraged and overcome with fear. But God is needing soldiers to get out of the pew and take hold of the power that God and Peter really said. Get up, get up. Get up in Jesus' name. For the Lord is calling daily for those who would be saved. But all go down the field of increase in the pain. Get up, get up. Get up in Jesus' name. Well, now at the gate called Beautiful, there lay down in the street a poor and lonely beggar who was crippled in his feet. As John and Peter passed him, they saw his knee was bad. We had no gold and silver, but they gave him what they had. They get up, oh, get up, oh, get up, Peter, Jesus' name. The Lord is calling daily for those who would be saved. Oh, don't go down defeated, all victories share the claim. Oh, get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. Oh, get up, 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 get up. Oh, the Lord is calling daily for those who would be saved. So I'll go down defeated, I'll be treated the same. Oh, get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. The gate called Beautiful, there lay down in the street a poor and lonely beggar who was crippled in his feet. Well, John and Peter passed there, they thought his day was bad. But we have no gold and silver, but they gave him what they had. They said, get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. The Lord is calling daily for those who will be saved. Don't go down defeated, I'll increase here to claim. Get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name. 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 Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Get up in Jesus' name. Get up in Jesus' name. Get up in Jesus' name. The Lord is calling daily for those who will be saved. Don't go down defeated while the king's here to claim. Get up, get up, get up in Jesus' name.